Welcome back, everybody. This is Bryce from VibrantDye. If this is your first time tuning in, welcome. If you're a returning viewer, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to be trying a new design I've been thinking of. It's a mandala fold with a honeycomb tie, and it gets you what I've been calling the Poka-dala. I've done a couple of them now. This one is getting closer, so I figured I'd post this one and show it to you guys. Also, bonus points if you can guess the song or the soundtrack that it came from that you're listening to in the background. I'll give you a little hint. It's from a spaghetti western. I've went ahead and marked every 20 degrees on the protractor. And we're basically doing large pleats till the lines meet each other up top. Once you have it all folded up like a normal mandala, here is where you'll start the honeycomb tie versus the mandala normal style tie. Tried to zoom in to show you the honeycomb tie. It's a little hard to kind of show. Rhea has a very good tutorial if you're trying to learn the tie. Check that out. I left the shirt at this angle because this really gives you a good idea of what the tie should look like from the side. What you see me using here is a waxed thread. It's not the same as sinew though. It's considered waxed cord. And we're just going over the sinews with this waxed cord just to really cinch down that tie. Here's another side shot of what it should look like tied up. The very tip, I went ahead and did a wig-wag type design for the center. I forgot to film that. It's oversaturated here, so you'll see me put my finger up. Like, it's not really what I was going for. But it looked cool at the end. You'll see the final result. This is a Gildan heavy cotton, so this is a thicker cotton, so I really wanted to show you guys, like, this is sped up 5 times faster than what I actually did it, so this, I'm trying to show you guys, like, how long it takes for the dye to absorb into the cotton, especially when it's this tight. Thank you. it's basically just drop by drop. It's a long process, but you don't want to oversaturate this because it'll distort the shape, especially if it's not tight enough around the sinew lines. I can show you a few examples in the reveal. Also, by only adding a majority of the dye up top, it'll let you see how far the dye is sinking down, which is why you'll see me flipping the project back and forth on the side. What I'm doing is I'm checking the saturation as it's going down. As you guys are fixing to see, I'm going to drop one little spot of blue on the back of my mandala here. Drives me nuts when I do that. And here it is, right there. Oh well, no biggie. This blue is really easy to see what I'm talking about with the saturation. You can see it puddle, and then you see it suck in to the fabric, it absorbs. The slower that absorption takes, the more saturated the area is a good rule of thumb. Just take your time with this process. You can just really go slow, or if it drives you nuts to kind of do this, you can do it in two different sessions. Go through it once, get it all colored, come back about 20 to 30 minutes later, let that dye get a chance to set in, and then apply a second coat. If you would like to do it that way, I would imagine it would work. after I finished dyeing this, I let it batch for the 48 hours because where I was batching was a little cooler. It was about 72 degrees, so I let it sit for the full 48 hours. Did a normal washout and didn't film any of the washout process. I'll just go ahead and skip to the reveal here in a second for you guys. Hopefully you guys like it. I'm pretty happy with the overall look of it here. I'm definitely happy with my color control. Did a really good job keeping the dye where I wanted it, so always something positive to take away from these things. Thank you guys for tuning in. This is Bryce from VibrantDye. Much love.